Hey guys, it's Snyder here again, and welcome back to another video, and today we're back in Need for Speed, and today we're suggested to do a grip build on the Toyota Supra, and this is going to be really interesting, because I haven't looked at any of the Supra kits yet, I really haven't bought the Supra yet, so this is going to be pretty interesting, and mainly because we're going to be doing a grip tune instead of a drift tune, which is normally what we've been doing. So we're gonna go ahead and purchase this and we'll customize it. Alright, so first off we're gonna take a look at the visual customization like usual. So let's just take a look at the body kits, because we usually do that first, like this Varus body kit, which looks pretty nice. There's no other body kit options, so it's just this Varus one. I feel like if I just, you know, customize every individual part, you know, including the bumpers and the fenders and whatnot, I feel like it could be a lot more expansive, and I can make the car look a lot nicer than just throwing on a body kit, because that will restrict us down to a few things. So first off, we're going to take a look at the front bumpers. So there's this really nice JUN front bumper. We also have a Need for Speed front bumper, but I think you all know which one I'm going to go with, because JUN bumpers on Supras are just absolutely amazing. So we're going to go ahead and throw that on. As far as the hood, we have just the stock one, and we have the JUN one. Once again, we also have a Varus hood, and we have a Need for Speed hood, but you know, I gotta match the front bumper, so I'm gonna go with the JUN hood. And now we're gonna go ahead and take a look at the fender. So we just have the stock fender, of course. We have a carbon fiber Need for Speed fender. Not a big fan of that. However, I'm a pretty big fan of that JUN fender, so yes, please. And now let's take a look at the side skirts. So we have oh my god, yes. That's our only option, or other than, you know, stock. But still, though, that looks amazing. Now let's take a look at the rear bumpers. So we have the JUN one, and that's the only option. So I'm going to go with that one, of course. And now we take a look at the beloved spoilers. So we just have the stock one, which I prefer. I don't really like aftermarket spoilers on a Supra. However, that Varus one looks a little weird. The APR Performance one looks nice. And there's a JUN one. Okay, this is going to be a little hard. That Need for Speed one looks really nice as well. Actually, all of these look pretty nice. I personally think, just for the sake of matching, I think I'm gonna go with the JUN spoiler. Plus, it looks pretty nice anyway. Alright, so now let's take a look at the exhaust pipes. Holy shit, there's a JUN exhaust pipe. There's some more Need for Speed ones, of course. And there's a nice Varus one. But you know what? I can't pass that up. Look at it. That thing is massive. So of course we're gonna go with the JUN exhaust pipe. That looks amazing. So honestly, I really do like these the stock Toyota rims, but come on, you know me, I have to choose some aftermarket rims, and I'm pretty sure I have a good idea of what would look nice on the car, and that is the Werkmeister S1 rims. So we're not gonna keep the gold. I think the gold looks a little weird on the Supra, but what we are going to do was I want to see how good black looks. I'm really interested to see how black looks. Oh yes, I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna apply to all rims, and then the secondary color, since the car is already red, I think I'm going to make the outer part of the rim red. Oh yes. So I feel like the rims look a little small, so I'm gonna go ahead and enhance the size of the rim. I'm gonna go just maximum, because that looks really nice. So there we go. I'm pretty sure I'm all done. I think one more thing I have to do is adjust the stance. That's one thing I forgot. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. We also forgot about the splitter. And oh shit. Okay, yeah. We have a JUN splitter. I totally forgot about the splitter. I'm really glad I remembered we still have the splitter. So you should know me by now. I like dropping the height all the way on the car, of course. The ride height rake is going to go toward the front. Track width is going to be interesting. So, you know, I'm actually going to put the camber on first, and then I'll adjust the track width. That's what I've noticed with my past few car builds, is you got to kind of adjust the camber. If you want full negative camber, you're going to have to do that first and then adjust the track width. So now I'm going to go ahead and change it from narrow to wide. So I think on the back, that looks just about perfect. Yeah, that looks perfect. And on the front, I'm gonna go all the way. No, I'm gonna go a few more in. There you go. That looks really nice. That, yes. Yes. So, I think I'm all done customizing the car. However, I'm going to do one more thing. And that one more thing, of course, is to tune the car, of course. Because we want this to be a grip monster. So, we're going to go ahead and tune the car before we hop in some events. So, with past experience, I know if you go full drift or full grip, it's a little overkill. So, I'm just going to have a little less tire pressure than, you know, in the middle. And the steer response, I want to keep in the middle. Steer range, I want that shit narrow. Brake drift assist off, of course. Stability assist off. Launch control off. I just want to keep all those things off. Then we have downforce. We want more downforce, of course. Brake strength, we want less. Brake bias, we want to let's go toward the front because it doesn't hurt to, you know, shift the brake bias toward the front. The handbrake strength, I want to go toward weak, just in case, you know, we do want to get the rear end out. Spring stiffness all the way, sway bars all the way, and the nitrous will keep in the middle. I don't think this thing is grippy enough on the master slider up at the top, so I'm going to go steer response. I'm going to have that go more towards slow, and then the tire pressure, I'll have that go toward the grip side a lot more. I think that's a little, let's just go all the way. So there we go. We're like 3/4 of the way to going full grip. So I think that would be perfect for our grip car. So since we're all done, you know, customizing this thing and tuning it, let's go ahead and see how it does in a race. All right, so now we are doing a sprint race. I kind of just wanted to start things off with sort of an easy race, just because this race is pretty much a straight shot. We're going on a freeway, so I want to see what I can top out this car at. And holy smokes, it sounds amazing. Now, I wasn't expecting, holy shit, there's a lot of supers in this race. But yeah, I wasn't expecting it to sound this good. I mean, I was expecting a super to sound decent, but I wasn't expecting it to sound this good. I think it's because of the JUN exhaust I put on, and wow, right there I had to go really slow entering that corner. And this is why I like my cars sort of in between drift and grip, or just completely drift, is because you could corner a lot better, I think, than right now, because I'm understeering quite a little bit and I'm going 130 miles per hour. So that's why I usually like my tunes in the middle of drift and grip. I'm not going to complain. It's just going to add a little more, bit more of a difficulty than normal. But yeah, this thing's going quick. I'm going to use my NOS. Let's see what we can get it at. We're at 195. And it's going to, I think 194 is the top speed, but I might be wrong. Holy shit. Okay, I don't want to eat shit through here. So I slow down like 60 miles per hour. No, you can't pass me, other Supra. Holy shit. Okay, this is going to be tight. Okay, yeah, I fucked up. All right, come on. We have 2 miles left. I don't know why those Supras just decided to spontaneously just go really slow, but they did. Luckily they did, because I just took first place back from them. Alright, so it's gonna get a little interesting through here, because I think we're getting off the freeway right here. So I think our top speed is 194. Don't quote me on that, but oh my god, okay, I probably should have braked a lot more than I did, because through there I could have understeered like a son of a bitch if I didn't already brake enough. But let's see how it e-brakes. See, it's a lot harder trying to get its rear end out. So I kind of want to keep first place. So it'd be kind of nice if those two just stayed behind me the remainder of my race. I only have like a quarter mile to go. But yeah, it's a lot harder to get this thing going sideways. And, you know, that's obvious because, you know, it is a grip car for the most part. So now I think I'm gonna go ahead and throw this thing into a circuit race. All right, so now we are in that circuit race, and this time we're gonna see how it handles in some tight city streets. But you know what, I still have to fanboy about the Supra still. It looks amazing. I just like what I did with the rims. That's probably my biggest love for the car that I built. But other than that, I mean, still, even then, just everything about this car and how I customized it, it just looks amazing. Alright, so here's our first corner right through here, or our second corner pretty much. But there was our first obstacle. I could have gone around that faster, I think, in a drift car, but still, it handled pretty well around that. As we go through yet again another corner, I think I went a little wide, but we still lived through that corner. But yeah, I don't think this race had as many turns as I thought. I mean, there's a few, but since this race really takes place in the city, I thought that we would come across more Troons than we've gone around, but yeah, we just ran into cops, of course, because we blasted right past a cop station. I think, yeah, we're gonna cool down right here, because we've gone pretty fast, and I was looking over at my my cooldown to see if, I was getting away from the cops, and of course, I didn't see the Troon right there. Still, though, luckily, we're in front of everyone. Like, everyone is really far back there. And of course, cops again. What a surprise. Alright, come on, Super. I'm gonna pull the handbrake again around this corner. It was a little harder to engage that drift, but, you know, still, even when you have, like, a grip-focused handling model, it still feels pretty good just to feel off, or to pull off a, just like a minor slide through that corner. But yeah, we're coming up on the end of this race, and of course, I would just have to run into someone right in the middle of the fucking street. But other than that, we finished this race first, so I think I'm going to end off this video right here. So if you guys did enjoy this video, be sure to leave a like, and also tell me in the comments below what other car you want me to build next time. So yeah, I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.